What is Sharia? Sharia is either the commandment of Allah, and commandment of Allah is just an abstract idea. There are no models of behavior in Quran. Aqimus Salah, you are supposed to perform your prayers. This is just an abstract idea. Model comes through Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Model of conduct, model of practice, model of following. That's why it is stated, "Qul in kuntum tuhibbun Allah fattabi'uni." If you love Almighty Allah and you love to obey the commandment of Almighty Allah, so there is no other way except following me. So Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, every movement of Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, every single word uttered by Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, every single act and deed committed and performed by Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam itself constitutes the body of Sharia. The whole body of Sharia has been originally and primarily and fundamentally constituted by two things, either by the commandment of Allah or by the commandment and practice of Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and there is nothing else which would make Sharia. So the Quran, commandments of Quran are just meanings, communications, messages, teachings, abstract ideas. And you can't do anything just basing on Quran, because Almighty Allah has never shown you how to pray. Allah is beyond that. Allah has never shown how to perform Hajj. Allah has never fasted, and He has never performed the way how to fast. He has never performed how to put the ihram on you. He has never performed any single, He has never practiced any single commandment of Him. He has just communicated His messages, His do's and don'ts, His commissions and His omissions to you. And He has left everything to personify it, to present it in a model form, to present it in a practicable form, to present it in a perceptible form, to present it in a conceptual form, to present it in a physical form, in a feasible form, in a workable form, in a viable form, in a visible form. All commandments of Almighty Allah became visible and became feasible just with the body and the personality of Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So that's why you can't go away from Holy Prophet. You can't get rid of. There is no directness between a man and God. This idea is absolutely, absolutely misguided. Nobody has ever seen Almighty Allah in His existence. Nobody has ever perceived Him, because He is not perceivable. Nobody has ever conceived Him, because He is not a conception. Nobody has ever understood Him, neither through our eyes, the five senses, nor through our ears. Conception without perception is blind. You can't formulate any conception, any idea in your mind without perception of through your senses. A child who is blind by birth, he has no conception of blue and red and green and white and black. Every conception is based on a perception. Unless you are able to perceive something physically in any form, you are totally unable to conceive it. So when conception is based on perception, are we able to perceive Almighty Allah's existence? No, answer is no. Then are we able to conceive Almighty Allah's existence? So He is beyond our perception and He is beyond our conception. That's why He just communicates His will, His commandment, His orders in the form of revelation. That's why He has raised the prophets and messengers to the mankind, so that whatever Almighty Allah wills, that is performed through the conduct and behavior of the prophet and messenger for the mankind. So the mankind is connected to the Prophet. The Ummah at the first stage, the immediate stage, the first and immediate level, the Ummah is supposed to get connected with Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam to receive the knowledge. Never, anyone, even Abu Bakr and Umar, never heard the revelation of Quran. They never knew even the distinction between Quran and the Hadith. When the first verses of Quran were being revealed, on Holy Prophet, Iqra bismi rabbikal ladhi khalaq. First five verses. He came out from the cave of Hira. He recited these verses first time. This was a new experience for the people, for his followers. They asked him, Ya Rasulullah, what are these words and sentences? We are hearing for you first time in our life. The language was Arabic. Nobody can ever imagine what is the difference between, this may be Holy Prophet's own message, his teaching. This may be a revelation. What is this? That was a natural question. So what was Holy Prophet's answer? His answer was, this is a very delicate thing. His answer was, this is Quran revealed on me. He recited the verses of Quran. He was asked by the companion, Ya Rasulullah, what is this? What is this paragraph? What are these sentences? What are these words? Responding their questions, Holy Prophet answered, he said, this is Quran revealed on me. Now, my question is from you. These were the verses, Iqra bismi rabbikal ladhi khalaq, five verses up to Allam al insana ma lam ya'lam. These were the five verses which was revealed in Cave of Hira, which Holy Prophet recited to companions. On these verses of Quran, they questioned and answered, Ya Rasulullah, what is this? And he answered, this is Quran which has been revealed on me when I was in Cave of Hira. Angel Jibrail came to me. He revealed these verses from Almighty Allah. He revealed on me through Angel Jibrail. So this is Allah's book. Now my question is, these words explaining the capacity, explaining the status, identifying those five verses, but this is Quran. Sheikh Nazim Bakhsh, my question is, these words, these sentences, this is Quran which Angel Jibrail brought to me when I was in Cave of Hira and this and that. All these sentences are Quran or Hadith of Holy Prophet. What are these sentences? Identifying that this is Quran which has been revealed on me. Are these verses the Quran itself? Or these are the sentences of Holy Prophet? This is Hadith of Holy Prophet. This is Hadith which identified the Quran. So when they heard the answer that these words are Quran revealed on me, then they accepted it. So the question is, what was the first stage of their faith? Did they accept directly Quran, or they first of all brought their faith in Hadith of Holy Prophet, and through Hadith of Holy Prophet, this Hadith led them to the Quran? Who opened the door of realizing the Quran in front of them? Who led them to the divine reality of Quran? Who took them to the divinity of Quran? Who made them realize that these are the Quranic verses revealed in Holy Prophet? This was Hadith which made them realized. This was Hadith which led them to the Quran. This was Hadith which took them to the divinity. So who became the means between the Sahaba and Allah? Prophet Muhammad became the means, and his words became the means. Allama Ibn Taymiyyah, he writes in his book As-Sarimul Maslul, page 42. He writes, فَقَدْ أَقَامَهُ اللَّهُ مُقَامَ نَفْسِهِ فَقَدْ أَقَامَهُ اللَّهُ مُقَامَ نَفْسِهِ فِي أَمْرِهِ وَنَهْيِهِ وَبَيَانِهِ فَلَا يُجُوزُ أَنْ يُفَرَّقَ بَيْنَ اللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ فِي شَيْءٍ مِّنْ هَذِهِ الْأُمُورِ. Allama Ibn Taymiyyah says that Almighty Allah has placed Holy Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam at his own station in these four things: fi amrihi wa nahyihi wa ikhbarihi wa bayanihi, in commandments of commissions, commandments of omissions, prohibitions, and giving the news of knowledge and news, and explaining and interpretation. Everything is covered under these four categories. In these four things, Almighty Allah has made Holy Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam his direct recipient, vicegerent, direct representative, مقام نفس ہی یو سے قائم مقام. When a president, for example, or prime minister goes, so he appoints till he returns vice president as the president. You say he is acting president. Muqama nafsihi means acting. Not nobody can become mazallah acting Allah. He is not away from his duty. Astaghfirullah. He doesn't disappear. But just to explain the thing, Muqama nafsihi, he has placed Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He has made him stand on his own place in these four things. Meaning thereby, its meaning is that in these four matters, Holy Prophet, his commandments has been given the same status and position as the commandments of Almighty Allah. And he says, it is absolutely unlawful and not permissible to differentiate between Allah and Holy Prophet. This is what Allama Ibn Taymiyyah says.